Good evening. My name is Ganesh Sagaram from Department of Radio Diagnosis, Osmani Medical College, Hyderabad. My topic is evaluation and characterization of orbital lesions using 128 slice multi-director computer tomography. The sophisticated and complex nature of orbital anatomy, presence of tiny and vital structures in relationship with surrounding facial bones, makes the diagnosis of orbital diseases extremely challenging. Often, misdiagnosis and incomplete treatment of orbital disorders leads to recurrence, functional, and cosmetic sequelae. Radiographs play an important role, but has diagnostic limitation in acute craniofacial trauma cases due to superimposition of surrounding bony structures, impaired visualization of underlying fine fractures due to periorbital edema, ecchymosis, and hemorrhage. Findings on plain radiographs and ultrasonography are not pathognomic of most of the orbital disease processes, though some help can be obtained in characterization of lesion in certain cases. Advent of CT and MRI has revolutionized the diagnostic imaging of orbit and its contents. CT is a simple, safe, and non-invasive diagnostic tool performed on an OPD basis. The information through CT scan can be enhanced by several special techniques like contrast enhancement, narrow density, window measurement, three-dimensional CT, and image reversal. The objectives of the study is to evaluate 128 slice multi-director CT as a modality to identify various orbital lesions and to characterize various orbital lesions on 128 slice MD-CT with histopathological correlation. The material and methods include: the study was conducted in Department of Radiology, Osmani Medical College, Hyderabad. Patients clinically suspected of having trauma to the orbits, proptosis, pain, visual impairment with or without ophthalmoplegia, orbital mass, were subjected to ophthalmological examination and CT orbit. CT findings were correlated with final diagnosis based on clinical, laboratory, operative findings, histopathological study, or response to treatment. The inclusion criteria was all patients clinically suspected to have orbital lesions referred to the Department of Radio Diagnosis in a period of 2 years from November 2019 to October 2021 will be subjected for the study. Any lesion originating in the orbit, any lesion invading the orbit from the paranasal sinuses, nose, or brain, cases of all age groups. Exclusion criteria: patients with pre-existing orbital fractures, post-operative and patients undergoing chemotherapy and radiotherapy, patients in whom contrast administration is contraindicated. Patients were subjected to CT examination prior to and after administration of intravenous contrast medium in a 128 MD-CT. The protocol used was the contiguous axial and coronal sections with 1 millimeter thin section slice thickness. The results were: out of the 40 subjects, more than half of the subjects were males, which constituted 22, whereas 18 were females in the present study, as depicted in the table 1. Out of 40 subjects, left side eye was more involved for 18 cases, followed by 12 cases which showed bilateral involvement, and 10 had right eye involvement, as depicted in table 2. Among the study subjects, majority of them belong to the age group of below 40 years, constituting 28 cases. Thyroid ophthalmopathy was seen in 20% of the study subjects, followed by orbital cellulitis, left chronic dacryocystitis, left orbital malignancy, secondaries, and bilateral lacrimal adenitis. Now, coming to case 1, this was a case of orbital metastasis, where you can see an heterogeneously enhancing soft tissue density lesions in bilateral retroorbital space involving both intra and extraconal compartment with erosion of right greater wing of sphenoid. Case 2, this was a case of thyroid ophthalmopathy. On axial CCT, it shows a bulky bilateral inferior recti muscles. In case 3, a case of a medial canthus dermoid, a well-defined cystic lesion with few fatty components at medial canthus of right eye can be noted. Discussion: 40 patients with orbital lesions were evaluated. Age of patients ranged from 1 year to 80 years. A slight male predominance was noted. Proptosis was most common complaint of patients in my study. My study is comparable up to some extent to previous studies. In pediatric age group, dermoid is the most frequently occurring case. In adults, Graves' disease and pseudotumor were more common. Orbital cellulitis was also more common lesion in my study. There were 28 unilateral cases and 12 bilateral cases. Extension outside orbit was seen in 9 cases. Orbital involvement from paraorbital structures was seen in 19 cases. Bony changes were seen in 3 cases. In a study conducted by E.A. Parthasarathy, among 102 patients, trauma constituted the most common etiology, followed by inflammatory and neoplastic. Lesions were analyzed for calcification, bony and paranasal sinus involvement, enhancement characteristics, lacrimal gland, and optic nerve involvement. Ben Simon et al. Studied 131 biopsy-proven cases of orbital lesions and found that benign lesions were more likely to be smaller in size, round or oval, constituting 29% of all benign tumors and associated with hyperostosis, with 22% of all benign lesions. Conclusion: CT is a modality of choice for assessing orbital lesions. Better information obtained by appropriated scanning technique and systematic analysis of CT characters of various orbital lesions. Appropriate window setting need to be done. Valsalva maneuver technique has to be used whenever needed. Axial, coronal, and sagittal sections to be taken in order to improve diagnostic accuracy. Distribution of lesion differs in children and adults. Dermoid was most common tumor in children, followed by orbital cellulitis. Any extraorbital extension or intracranial extension helps in assessing prognosis. Compartmentalization helps in arriving at a diagnosis. CT also helps monitoring response to treatment. CT was accurate in narrowing differential diagnosis. These were my references.